What we are going to do now is we're going to create a simple login app where you can have a user log in with their username and password and then test that they're allowed into the app. I'm going to create a new project and call it My Login App. So in the My Login App, we're just going to ask them to input a username, password, and have a submit button. To do that, we're going to add two horizontal arrangements, one underneath the other. And we are going to make their width fill parent. And then we're going to add two labels. So a label, didn't get that one, fill parent. So we'll add a label there and a label there and a text box. We'll add a text box and a text box. And then below it all, we're going to add a button. And to make this look a little prettier, I'm going to go to screen one and change the alignment to center. The first one is going to be the label for username. So let's rename that username label. And then I'll rename this username text box. And the label we want to say username. Okay, the second label is going to be password label. And that's going to have its text say password with a colon. And I made a mistake by adding a simple text box, so I'm going to get rid of that, the second one. So delete that. And App Inventor has this special password text box. So I'm going to drag that in. And you can see with the asterisk here that it won't let you see the password. It's going to cover it up. So it's a special password text box. And we will just leave that name as password text box one. The bottom here, that's going to be our submit button. So let's rename that and have the text say submit. And then the other two things we're going to need are under storage, we're going to add this CloudDB component. So CloudDB is a database that lives in the cloud. So it actually lives on a server. Things that are in the cloud really are just on a computer server somewhere, but it allows you to communicate between computers and laptops and phones. So we call it cloud computing. So we're going to store our usernames and passwords for our app in the cloud database. So that way anyone that's using our app can log in and we can check their username and password that they're allowed in. The other thing we're going to do is add a notifier. So go back to user interface and notifier. This is going to allow us to just add messages to our app. This is it for the designer. So let's go to the blocks. This should be simple enough to do. So what's going to happen is the user is going to type in a username and password. So there's going to be three things that can happen. One, we find the username and the matching password, and we go ahead and let them in. And in this case, we're going to let them move on to screen two in our app. So it's like unlocking the app. Second option is that we find the username, but the password doesn't match. So we'll tell them, wrong password. Third option is that we can't even find the username in our app. And if that's the case, we're going to say, well, it looks like you haven't registered yet. Do you want to register? And we let them register and we'll add them to the database. So what's going to happen is everything's going to be triggered when they hit the submit button. So we're going to have when submit button.click. Let's first make sure that they've typed something into both the username text box and the password text box. So we want to make sure that both of those are not empty. So what we're going to do is add an if then else. And we want to check both things. We're going to use an and. And we're going to check if something's not empty. So go to logic, not, and text is empty. And we're going to look for the username text box dot text. And then I'm going to duplicate all that because we want to check both that and the password text box. So let's go to password text box one dot text and add that in there. I'm going to do this little trick where I'm going to right click and say external inputs just to make that a little bit easier to read. So they're vertical instead of going across the workspace here. Okay, so we're checking if they're both not empty, meaning they've typed something into username and password, Now let's check. We're going to check to see that we can find that username. So we're going to say, get me the value. What we're going to do is use as the tag our username. So the CloudDB has two things, a tag and a value. So the tag is like the name of something, and in this case it makes sense, it's the username. And then the value is what's attached to that tag. And in this case, what's attached to the tag, or the thing we need to check, is the password. So what we're going to say, well, if I can't find that, I'm going to say not found, and that will be our trigger. The username's not there. Okay, so the user submits, and we go off to CloudDB and say, hey, find that username and return the password. And what we have to do is wait for CloudDB to go ahead and find that information and send it back to us. So there's this block called CloudDB.gotValue. So when it's got the value, it'll send it back to the app, and it returns the tag and the value. So what we're going to do is check. We're going to check if, and from logic, grab an equals. We're going to say if the tag, not value tag. And I'm going to duplicate this up here, username text box. So if the tag is the username that we just submitted, and what we're going to do is check if, in this case I'm going to use an if then else, we have two possibilities here, and I'm going to check if, in this case, the values, the value is going to be the password. If the value matches what's in the password text box, we're good to go. So what we're going to do is say, go ahead on to screen two. I haven't created screen two, so I'm going to do that now. So I'll just add another screen. Let's just throw in a label here to say, you made it. So we can tell that we've made it to screen two. Let's go back to screen one and the blocks. So if the username and password match, let's go ahead to control and say, open another screen. And the name of the screen will be screen two. If the password doesn't match, we've actually got two other options that I mentioned. So one would be that the username doesn't exist. So what I'm going to do is add in here, actually another else if above the else. So here are our three options. First, we're checking if it's a match, username's there, password's there, pass them on to screen two. Otherwise, we could say if, and I'm going to duplicate that, if the value equals what's up here, so I'm going to copy that, not found. If that's the case, we said if the tag's not there, we're going to return not found. So that means we can't even find the username. So in the case where the username wasn't found at all, let's give them the option to sign up. And we can do that with the notifier. And there's this show password dialog. So what we're going to do is say, we'll enter the password again and we'll sign you up. So let's go to text and drag out blank text box. Copy and paste that. All right, so the title will be new user. And then we could say something like, user not found. If you'd like to sign up, type your password again. And we'll set this cancelable to true. So there's the option to cancel out of that if they really don't want to sign up and they just made a mistake. Third option is just that the password was incorrect. So we'll use the notifier again, but do a show alert. So we will say, let's drag out a text block. We'll just say incorrect password. Now we have to deal with this option here where they typed in the password with the new user. So what we're going to do is go to notifier and we're going to say after text input. So the text input will be their response. So they're going to get a dialog box to input the password again. And so what we want to do is just check, does that password match the original one? So what we're going to do is drag out an if block. So first we want to say, well, wait a minute, did they choose to cancel? Let's drag out an equal, but then let's put a not in front of it. So we're going to say if response is not, if response is not equal to cancel. Okay, so if they choose not to cancel, they obviously want to sign up. So we're going to add an if-then-else block, and we'll say from logic.
We're going to pull out an equals, and we're going to check if the response, which should be the password that they just typed in, is going to match, and I'm going to copy up here, password text. So that means that the original password they typed in and this new password we asked them for match. And if that's good, let's go ahead and save that in CloudDB. So in this case, we're going to store the username and password as a new user. So let's duplicate username and duplicate password. And we'll store that. The other option here is that the password they've typed in here doesn't match their original password. So we just want to let them know that. So let's do a show alert and grab a text block. And we're going to say passwords don't match, try again. And that should do it. Let's test this out. So I'm going to go to connect emulator. Wait for the emulator to start up. So here is the app running on my emulator. I'm going to type in, say, Joni, and I'll make up a password, Jojo. So because Joni's not in my database, it's going to say, user's not found. Would you like to sign up? So I'm going to go ahead and put in an incorrect password. So I'll just put Joni again. And OK. And it says, passwords don't match. Try again. So I'll hit submit. Again, the user's not found. Let's just check that cancel works. So canceling works. So let me put in that password, which was J-O-J-O, and see if that works. Okay, so it at least came back without a message, but it looks like something should have happened, right? We actually want to go to screen two. So looking at our code, I forgot to add that piece. So I stored Joni in my database, but then I also want to go to screen two. So I'm going to duplicate this up here and add that block. Despite the fact it didn't take me to screen two, it still did store Joni in there. So I should be able to get in with Joni and my password, Jojo. And there you go. It takes me to screen two. Now I haven't made a back button or anything here, so I'm just going to manually go back to screen one up here. And let's try again, Joni, with the wrong. So let's try Joni again, the wrong password, and make sure we get that incorrect password. So it gives me then the option to, you know, correct that to Jojo again. And I can go to screen two. So let me try another person in here. So I'll put in Gina, and I'll put in a password, App Inventor. Okay, so it says user not found. And so I will repeat App Inventor as my password. And it takes me to screen two that time. And then I can go back to screen one. So that appears to work. So we've actually covered the three cases here. So we've got a new user, and we're allowed to put in a new password and store that, and it will let the user in as a new user. Second option is when the password doesn't match, it asks us to put in a new password. And then the third option is when we've got a good match right up front. The username works and the password works, so it lets us into screen two. That's the beginning of a good app. The idea would then be your screen one is for your login, very simple code here. And then your screen two would be the bulk of your app here, right? So you'd start to build what your actual app needs to do. Just remember that login screen is a minor part of your app. People are really going to want to see what your app does beyond the user login. So try to get through that quickly and then move on to really the meat of your app, which will be starting here in screen two. So good luck with that.